going to raise it a little bit. Just don't like the sound of this A. So that shows the relativity of temperaments. Just try that one passage, the rest is okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
You will not have much tape. How much is there?
One-third.
Still one-third. Okay. There are some drills that are so difficult. I shouldn't have played with Evelyn this morning. Yeah, you told me to.
Thank you.
I think you can better rewind the tape and just take a new one for the jig. So normally in a concert those trills wouldn't of course be a problem, but it's really tricky on the clavichords. And it's a great quality of this instrument that it has a very long tone. But sometimes I wish it wouldn't have that, like in the last chord. I mean, this F sharp sounds forever. And if it wouldn't sound that long, I could just release that and play the E, position my hand for the E. And it always would work, but now I have to keep that and I have to use my fourth finger in a very awkward position. But for a concert I would never do that. Because obviously the quality of the last E is what decides the ending of the piece and the all overall feeling that a listener has. So, and certainly in a room where there are people, you will not hear the F sharp, that just silences itself a little bit too early. But the Neumann twins, so to say, they hear everything. And when I succeed in doing that, just have this F sharp very long and also the A, and I'm going to this legato, cantabile wise, it's so much better. So we go for the best. You could say the recording is a little bit artificial in that way. It is, of course, it's not a live snapshot, it's not a live concert, and the reason is because if you listen to that over and over again with every time the same little small mistake, it wouldn't make sense. It's not a proof that one can play or not play or has practice or not practice, it's just an attempt to give, to create the best result that's possible. And those details, I want to have them good. Okay, if Anya's ready for the jig, then we're going to do the final piece. So we wait for the signal. Like that?
Yeah. Almost.
Almost.
Thank you.
Yep. So that was it. Just drink a little bit of my tea and then I go to the chat. All six partitas done.
Did someone ask which edition you played from?
This is just the Dover edition, so the 19th century first Bach Gesellschaft Ausgabe, so the first Bach edition, and that's a very good one. So you might want to check the other sources, like the Neue Bach Ausgabe, for instance, or the Händel Verlag, which is also very good. But this follows the manuscript or the first edition very, very precisely, even with the mistakes that in that first print are. But overall, this is a very clear print, and I like playing from that. Only the six partita needs turn. I needed to make copies for page turning, so that's the reason. Okay. Anya will probably come and tell me if I've missed something. I will just go through your the chat if I missed a great... Oh, la 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 la.
I think, and there was someone else who reminded me of it, so I think he deserves something like this.
Really?
I think so, yes.
A Belgian beer. Mm-hmm. So I taste on your health.
Yes, I didn't drink it. So
support of all of you and of Bach. So
Sophie,
great moment. If you've never been to Belgium,
is it better than tea or not?
Well, if you've never been to Belgium, I can tell you two things. There is a very good clavichord you can see, and you're welcome to play, and you get a Belgian beer. If Costa still is in the chat, he will tell you how good Belgian beer is.
And I think it was someone from Finland. I think she's gonna call, or he's gonna call now.
Great.
Sophie.
Matthias Valente. Olaf Bach. Yeah, that's a great project. Mikael also talking about that. I really would have liked to be in that project, and I applied. I didn't know about it a few years ago, and people said to me, I have to apply for that. But it's a Dutch program, you know, and we are not living
Dutch.
In it is Dutch.
Okay.
Olaf Bach.
Okay.
I think, yeah, I'm sure it is. But they have great players, so they don't need me. So I think Menno van Delft is doing a great deal with Sieben Henstra. And I saw Menno's recording of the Chromatic Fantasy and Fugue on what was Gustav Leonhard's clavichord, so the big Kramer 18-2 clavichord, I think. It's a great, great recording. But I would have liked to be in that project. But anyway, it's great.
I don't know his name. Thought you could join.
Matthew. No, so I answered that. Mm-hmm. Not the hand edition. Hand is very good, but has awkward fingerings. So here I make my own. And I will actually publish my own score. Make my own edition with the annotated fingerings, and that will go along with the vinyl box with the partita. So that will be a Gesamtkunstwerk, so to say. And then I go handle Terotopia from Finland. All right, I have beer now, you have seen it, huh? We'll make a picture and make the thumbnail of that. Philip, welcome. Yeah, and my aunt,
okay,
Tante Rita, typically ask if I drink alone, but Anya doesn't drink any alcohol.
You should know that, Tante Rita.
And she is sitting in the kitchen, so we don't know what she's doing.
We are recording it.
I only see that when I upload the file from the camera on my computer. But I never check. So, okay.
Okay. And just, you said it now?
I didn't miss anything else, huh?
No, I don't think so. No.
CSGO player. Wonder what that stands for. And then, okay. Anyway, I'm a little tired. I feel a little bit my arm here because I was playing with some small papers tomorrow with Evelyn. I can't explain in English. And Aina said, take care of your... It's when I play a lot, I have to take care of doing stupid things like just very fine things. And I have my arm hurt now from the drills here. But that's life of a musician.
Okay.
I'm going to finish my beer. I'm going to think on Bach's Partitas and all of you who supported me, and of course, Aya and Sophie. Great to have them here in the kitchen. Sophie will be the recording engineer number two, I think, in a few years. I don't translate what I'm saying now. You should learn English.
You have to learn English,
Sophie. Up to the next projects. The rest of February will be a little bit a weird month for Authentic Sound. 1st of March, I will announce the schedule for what's coming up. And before that, I will be releasing my full piano CD. I think after I've released this live session, which will be on... what day is it today?
Sunday.
It's Sunday. Oh, sorry, this will go on Thursday, and so probably from then on I will be releasing all those pieces one by one. And before that I have a great interview with about tempo and metronome numbers and things like that, just things that we maybe should talk about a little bit more.
Okay.
Thank you again, have a nice evening, nice day, nice morning, nice night.
Oh. Thank
I'm
you
the luckiest man in the world, you know that. See you next time. Bye. Okay.